Everyone, today I am starting a new series about all about SDRs and how to use them. So today is about the beginner's guide to SDR. First, we're talking about hardware and what to get. Now, most people get all sorts of things, but we are doing the common one, the RTL.SDR. I chose this because there's lots of documentation on this. There's tons of info, forms, and the website is great. It's fully aluminum, and it actually has a really good band for the price that I paid. Now, this is all you get, and it's not much. So a lot of people are tempted to try out getting the kit. That's what I got. The kit includes two big antennas and small little antennas, and includes an antenna stand. And most people tell you that these antennas suck, and obviously they are right, they do suck. But there's actually a way you can get better reception with these antennas because it actually comes with this extender cable. This cable is like 6 feet, but this cable actually makes a huge difference. If it's spanned out like a long antenna, it can make a difference between no shortwave and getting shortwave. So this is exactly how you get started, so let's set it up for you. So we're just gonna do it without the long cable so it's clean. So this is an SMA connector. You'll find this in the back of computers. This antenna gets pretty long. Gets to a good, I would say, 5 feet probably, 6 feet maybe. All the instructions are on the website, link in description. Today we're just gonna use the small itty bitty antennas because it'll fit in the camera. These things only get to like, I would say it's about 5-6 inches, barely. These are only good for, you know, smaller frequencies. You can get some FM radio with these, but don't expect too much on these. They really don't do much. I think they're more for portability. It also includes a tripod, which I don't have with me because I actually lost it. But I actually mainly use the suction cup. This thing's great because, let's get my phone case here. Actually, suction mounts to whatever. It's great for windows and very smooth walls. It does great with windows especially, so you can suck it right onto your window. So this is your common setup. This is what you're going to start with. Next episode is going to be on installing the drivers and software. But let's see what else you can expect when starting out with SDR. Let's say you want to take it up a notch. What you would get would be a ham it up device. This thing is great. It's a up converter. And what it does is it gets very low frequencies, converts it up to the HF band, where you can use AKG or whatever it's called to, you know, tune into your stations more precisely. It comes with this little adapter here, so you can plug your SDR directly into it, like so. Just screw it on. And boom, SDR. You want to go to IF out. It's a little lopsided, as you can see right there. And then the antenna screws right into here. But honestly, when it comes to low frequencies, these won't cut it. Even with the 6 foot extender, won't cut it. So what I decided to do, and this works great by the way, is I got this adapter. This is $8. Link in description below if I can find it again. Plug that in there, and this is where the real stuff comes in handy. 100 feet of speaker wire, and if you want to get fancy, you can split the wire in half and get 200 feet. Although I don't do that because what I do is I do the black or the ground onto one half, and do the other half on the other side. So it's definitely a double antenna. Of course, you would have to strip the wire, clamp it on. And you would do both. If you want better reception, you ground the ground part here. You ground this, and you get better reception. Of course, this is a multi-part series where I'm going to be showing you all sorts of stuff and how to do things based on my findings. The first set of videos will be with the built-in stuff that came with the SDR, so you guys can easily follow along. We're going to start with FM radio. That is the easiest to pick up and to tune in. And we're going to teach you how to use SDR Sharp. Stay tuned for the next episode.